so-called Western forces of Texas and California have suffered a very great defeat.
Hey everybody, so Civil War is new in theaters. Now wait, don't get upset. It doesn't deal in any of our real life politics or take sides. It's apolitical, really, and fictional. I mean, Texas and California are on the same side in this movie, so yeah, fictional. But it definitely hits close to home in these divided times. It follows a team of war journalists led by Kirsten Dunst as they navigate a war-torn U.S. combat zone, a nightmare what-if. And it's harrowing and depressing and scary. Well done. It's playing everywhere.
You have to stay vigilant. You understand?
But new on select area screens is Arcadian, Nicolas Cage and sons fighting monsters at the end of the world. Also another horror movie, Sting, about a giant man-eating spider on the loose. A true sports story, The Long Game, about a Latin golf team fighting racism in the 50s with Jay Hernandez, Cheech Marin, and Dennis Quaid.
I know how to discipline you. I watch Madea movies.
And Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter's Dead. Yeah, a remake of the 90s teen classic, this one starring Bel-Air, Simone Joy Jones, and Nicole Richie. In special events in local theaters, Shrek 2 back everywhere all week. It's turning 20. Selena is back on select screens for Selena's birthday. AMC kicks off Spider-Man Mondays. All the Spider-Man movies coming back in order, one a week. And all the Cinemarks in the area doing a fantastic vampire fest all week. Dracula, Twilight, Blade, Dust Till Dawn, The Lost Boys, Interview with the Vampire. Great ones. Check listings for those wheres and wins.
What is it you're holding?
A cookie?
All right, then moving on. Kung Fu Panda 4 is already new at home on premium VOD. So is One Life, the Holocaust drama with Anthony Hopkins, and Sleeping Dogs with Russell Crowe as a detective who's lost his memory. Then new on cheaper demand, Damaged with Samuel L. Jackson as a Chicago cop in Scotland to hunt a killer. Parachute, directed by actress Brittany Snow, about a woman with an eating disorder with Courtney Eaton of Yellow Jackets, Dave Bautista, and Kid Cudi. And the documentary sequel Food Inc. 2, which updates us on the state of our food industry. Uh-oh.
What if I can save him? What if I can change that moment and the accident never happened?
Then on to streaming we go, where Hulu premieres the movie The Greatest Hits, about a woman who, when listening to her favorite song, zaps back in time, with Lucy Boynton of Bohemian Rhapsody and the next Superman, David Corenswet. Then Peacock adds Drive Away Dolls from theaters, the crime comedy from one of the Coen brothers.
The state called, and they want to cut you a disability check for your face.
Netflix premieres Good Times, a new adult animated reboot of the 70s sitcom. Also a new live-action sequel, Woody Woodpecker Goes to Camp. And Dora the Explorer is back for a new reboot on Paramount+. Amazon Prime, meanwhile, just kicked off Fallout, their big new post-apocalypse action series based on the popular video games. Apple TV adds Argyle from theaters, the spy comedy with Bryce Dallas Howard and Sam Rockwell, and Apple premieres Franklin.
That's just the sort of game I like.
That's their big new historical series starring Michael Douglas as Benjamin Franklin. And then finally coming Sunday to HBO and Max, The Sympathizer, their new Vietnam spy series that features Robert Downey Jr. in all sorts of multiple roles. That's a look at what's new from the director's chair.